Hey guys, I hope y'all are doing good. So in today's video, I'm going to talk about BIM and studying BIM in Canada. And guys, if you are remotely interested in BIM or studying BIM anywhere around the world, this video will be a really helpful video for you all. And in this video, I'm going to talk about what is BIM, what is the status of BIM in Canada, and what all softwares you will be requiring while, you know, learning BIM, what all softwares you will learn while studying this BIM course in Canada, and I will talk about my experience while studying BIM in Canada and what are the opportunities after you study BIM in Canada. So all these points I'll be covering, and guys, this video will be a really helpful video for you all. So try watching this video till the end, and guys, I'll try to cover all the points in detail. So without wasting any time, let's get started with the video. So guys, let's get started with point number one, that is, what is BIM? So building information modeling, or BIM, is a holistic process of creating and managing information for a built asset based on an intelligent model and enabled by a cloud platform. BIM integrates structural multidisciplinary data to produce a digital representation of an asset across its life cycle, from planning and designing to construction and operation. So guys, in simple term, BIM is something that, you know, links every data and every aspect of a construction into a central uniform information system. So what happens is, whenever or whatever you are building, so it contains information. Every information and every data is centralized over here. So this data is available for all the parties in a construction project. So what happens, the flow of data and the information exchange that happens on a very smooth basis, and ultimately what it results into is, you know, lag-free or error-free data flow, first of all. Second is, it saves you a lot of time, and third thing is, it saves you a lot of money also. So, you know, there are less error on site, there are less communication gaps on site. So these things are a major issue till now in, you know, around the world, in major construction hubs like Dubai also. They haven't started integrating BIM on a very large scale, but yeah, BIM is something that can reduce your time, reduce your money, and increase your performance and increase the output that you can give in a limited amount of time. So guys, now let's talk about point number two. What is the current status of BIM in Canada? So majority of the construction industry and architectural industry in Canada are actively using BIM, but yet there is no government mandate that has been given to construction and architectural industry in Canada that you have to use BIM on this projects or all the projects that you are doing. So still there is a lot to cover. BIM is in an initial stage, and according to me, this is a good time to enter into this field where you can learn and where you can develop different standards and where you can be a part of initial team. So there are multiple levels in a BIM environment where you can fit in based on what you like and what your expertise lies in. Now let's talk about the subjects that you'll be getting to learn in this whole course. And I think so all the colleges have the similar subjects, or, you know, just the name will be different, but the subjects will be almost similar to this. So first subject is standards and guidelines. In this subject, what they will be doing is, they will be teaching you the standards. So there are ISO standards that are around the world and that has been developed specially for, you know, BIM. And this makes the process more simpler and more easier for information exchange. Now comes your subject number two, that is BIM Fundamental. In BIM Fundamental, you'll be learning softwares, and especially Revit and other linking software to the BIM. So this is also a very important subject. Then you will have workflow and collaboration. And BIM, as you know, BIM needs a lot of collaboration. and this subject specially will focus on this, where you will be collaborating with your teammates. Your entire class will be divided into many different groups, and then you will be doing a project that they will give, and then you have to come up with a proposal. And right now everyone is in their, you know, country and their states or something like that, and we are, you know, miles and thousands of miles apart, and still we are able to do a project. Like, I wasn't able to do a project, a group project, when I was in college. So there's a lot to learn, and you know, there is a whole new field out there for you when you will be going on and learning these subjects. And now coming to next point, that is what softwares you need to know. So first thing first, guys, you need to know AutoCAD, you need to know Revit. This will make your life 10 times easier in adapting all those things. And if possible, you guys can go ahead and learn Navisworks. You guys can go ahead and see about Revitso, what is Revitso. You can see how MS projects work. And these softwares are basic softwares that you will need to learn before you enter this course. And the other softwares, most of the softwares, they will be teaching you. But if you know the basics of all these softwares, it will be a much easier task for you to, you know, manage everything throughout your course, and it will be a very easy course for you guys. Now talking about the opportunities that you will get after completing your BIM from this college. So guys, right now I'm here in India, but many of my classmates and many of the people that I know through LinkedIn and, you know, alumni of this college, they have gotten good jobs and they are working as BIM modeler or architecture technician or something like that. Because these are entry level jobs, because you don't have any prior experience in BIM or this environment. Initially, you will be doing an entry level job anywhere you go in Canada, but that's how you will grow. At least you will need 1 year of Canadian experience, and then you can, you know, jump onto a higher level or a different perspective of job. But overall, I think so it's a good course to do. You will learn a lot, and guys, BIM is something that is coming and it is inevitable. You have to learn BIM, you have to learn these softwares, because in future collaboration is the key. If we can't collaborate among ourselves, I don't think so any projects can be successful. So guys, BIM is the future, and if you are not even doing this course, go ahead, learn all these softwares, learn about what is AutoCAD 360 or BIM 360. A lot is out there. If you know all these things, future will be a really good deal for you. So now coming on to the last and the final point of this video, that is my experience, my personal experience while doing this course. So first thing first, if you are interested in architecture, if you are interested in 3D modeling, if you are interested in softwares, this course is for you. You will enjoy this course. So my first point is that. And one thing that I missed, you know, being here in India, was like, you know, there was no interaction with my classmates, very less interaction with my professors. You can have good interactions with them. All the professors are pretty good in this college, and I think so even George Brown has the same faculties as we have in this college. So things are almost similar in George Brown and Algonquin. Things would have been very much different for me and for all the people who are doing this course if this course was on campus and if this COVID scenario wasn't there. So yeah, that's one thing that I regret. Like, you know, this course should have been in person. I would have learned so much more and done so much more. But yeah, still it's good. I did the entire course sitting at home and in my comfort zone, so I can't complain. Next thing that I missed was, you know, the exposure that I wanted. I thought that this is a co-op course, but yeah, again, due to COVID, nothing happened, and again, that was a thumb down for me. But still, overall, this course is pretty good. My experience was good enough, and even your experience will be nice. if you are interested in software, if you are interested in architecture. This is not all about design or something. This is more about collaboration. This is more about using different softwares. This is more about using BIM interface overall. So it's a bit different than, you know, traditional architecture design. Design part is there, which is around, you know, 40%, and 60% is software collaboration and things like that. And if you like all those things, go ahead and do this course. I am damn sure you won't regret it. And guys, if you have any kinds of doubts or queries or anything, go ahead and mention it in the comment section below. I will try my level best to solve those queries. And if you like this video and if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, go ahead, hit a subscribe. Your support does matters. It does encourages me, motivates me to keep helping you all, and motivates me to keep making such videos on a regular basis. And guys, on this note, I'll end this video. Take care of yourself and I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.